As I mentioned in my opening, the pandemic is strengthening, and so too must our response. 2 weeks ago, Chair Powell, when I asked you about the need for more congressional action to protect our communities, you said, and I quote, "There are something like 25 million people who are still dislodged from their job in full or in part due to the pandemic. I would think it would be a concern if Congress were to pull back from the support that it's providing too quickly," end quote. Unfortunately, tomorrow this is exactly what will happen if the Senate does not pass the HEROES Act. Tomorrow the PPP program stops taking new loan applications. The PPP should be extended immediately so that the remaining $135 billion in funding can support small businesses. Also happening tomorrow, millions of families will be unable to pay their rent and mortgages. In June, one-third of renters couldn't pay rent. 4.2 million homeowners are currently in forbearance because they're unable to pay their mortgages, and evictions have already started in many states where local eviction moratoria have expired. While the moratoria should be extended, it is not conscionable. To simply delay an eviction and foreclosure crisis. Congress and the administration must provide support to struggling low-income families to cover their rent and utility payments. So, Chairman Powell, millions of families are at risk of being stripped of their home. Do you think Congress should provide financial assistance to ensure people stay in their homes?
Thank you, Madam Chairwoman. I tried to keep my fiscal comments at a very high level, and that comment you referred to was referring to the unemployment insurance that expires at the end of July. And I think for the specifics of what you need to be doing, I think we have the Treasury Secretary here, and I would defer to the Treasury Secretary on fiscal matters here.
Okay, so you put it off on Mr. Mnuchin, so. While you've made some changes to broaden the municipal liquidity facility, many jurisdictions like the territories are still locked out. When we last spoke, you mentioned that it was difficult, but perhaps there was a way that Guam may be eligible. Did you find a way to take a serious look at that and determine whether or not something could happen?
Yes, we are taking a serious look at that. So the territories themselves are not investment grade rated, and they were not before the pandemic set in, and that's the minimum standard for access to the municipal liquidity facility. Of course, businesses in the territories would be eligible for the Main Street facility. Some of the revenue based facilities that that Guam has are investment grade rated, but below the minimum, and we're actually reviewing our credit standards in the municipal liquidity facility at the moment to determine if there's a way to adjust the facility in a way that would make eligible some creditworthy issuers without sort of violating the spirit or letter of Section 13.3.
Thank you. Secretary Mnuchin, with critical unemployment support expiring next month and today marking the last day that Treasury and SBA claim that new PPP loans can be approved, does the administration support extending these programs as proposed in the HEROES Act?
Well, we do support additional legislation, and we look forward to working with the House and the Senate on that. As it relates to the PPP, I've already had conversations with the SBA committee and the Senate about repurposing that $135 billion and think that should be done, and look forward to working with both the House and the Senate so that we can pass legislation by the end of July.
Thank you.